Hi students, this is Kameshwari from Nalla Narasimharedi Education Society group of institutions. My subject geotechnical engineering. In already previous classes we are already discussing about condition head method, variable head method, that means falling head method, and stress distribution, stress due to self rate. In the last class, discuss first layer is dry condition, second layer will be saturation condition. Simply you can write in layer 1 1 sigma is equal to 0, pore water pressure is equal to 0, effective stress is equal to 0. From layer 2 2 total stress, what is written here? Sigma d into z. Pore water pressure equal to 0. And effective stress is equal to sigma minus u. Total stress minus neutral stress. Gamma d into z minus 0 equal to gamma d into z. And total stress per layer 3 3. Gamma d into z plus gamma sat into h. And pore water pressure gamma w into h. Now sigma dash effective stress is equal to total minus neutral stress. Gamma d into z plus gamma sat into h minus gamma w into h. So you can come on h. Gamma sat minus gamma w. In the place of gamma sat minus gamma w, you can written as gamma submerged, gamma dash. The second model of pressure distribution diagram. Here pressure distribution diagrams is very important. After solving the problem, at the end of the problem, must and should you can draw these diagrams. Here condition is, first layer is water, that means moisture. Second layer is saturation condition. First layer is water, saturation condition. Water means some of the water. Saturation is the entire void is only filled by water only. So, what is the first step? The first step is total stress. The total stress definition, what is the definition of total stress? The definition of total stress is, it is defined as that particular layer unit weight multiplied by that particular layer depth. So this is the ground surface. That particular layer is water. So gamma w, that particular layer depth is hw. Here indication, either we can written as z or h or d, water may be. Water may be the z or depth or h or z or d. So gamma w into hw. And in total stress, the bottom layer at layer 3 3, from top to bottom, for second layer gamma w into hw, that particular layer unit weight multiplied by particular layer depth, gamma w into hw. Either dry condition or saturation condition or water condition, water maybe, just we can simply kept in mind. What is that? You can simply write unit weight multiplied by that particular depth, layer depth. So here water condition, so gamma w, so gamma, that particular layer unit weight, that particular layer unit weight is gamma w, and depth is h w, plus for layer 3 3, layer 3 3 saturation condition. So what is the total stress definition? The total stress definition is, already we can discuss unit weight multiplied by height. That unit weight, what is the unit weight? Saturated unit weight. So you can written as saturated unit weight multiplied by that layer depth is z. So gamma saturation into z. Next comes to pore water pressure. Here water table will be there. Water will be there or first layer, second layer. Yes, second layer will be water condition. So you can right, gamma w into h w. In this is also particular pore water pressure means if particular layer consists of a water, we can mention that equation. Otherwise, simply make it as zero. So here gamma w into h w, and second layer, third layer, gamma w, the first layer will be zero, second layer gamma w into h w plus in last layer gamma w into z. Here moisture content will be there na, in saturation condition, that's why you can make it as gamma w into z. Finally, you can written as sigma dash is equal to, that is equal to effective stress is equal to total stress minus neutral stress is equal to effective stress. Sigma dash is equal to sigma minus u. Total effective stress is equal to total stress minus neutral stress. So here first comes to down. In first layer 1 1, sigma is equal to zero, pore water pressure is equal to zero, and effective stress sigma dash is equal to zero. And second layer total stress sigma is equal to, what is sigma? Gamma w into h w. Just we can write gamma w into h w. Next, neutral stress pore water pressure for layer 2 2. Just I am talking about layer 2 2. Layer 2 2 means this is the layer 2 2. For total stress gamma w into h w, and pore water pressure also gamma w into h w. Why? Because of what will be there. Just we can find out moisture content, gamma w h w. So finally sigma dash is equal to sigma minus u. Here you written as zero. Why you can written as zero? Sigma dash is equal to sigma minus u, our equation. What is sigma? Gamma w into h w. Gamma w into h w minus pore water pressure gamma w into h w. So gamma w into h w, gamma w into h w cancel. This one cancel. So that is equal to zero. That's why we can written as sigma dash is equal to zero. The diagram will be changed as zero. And next, effective stress sigma minus u. In third layer, what is sigma? Gamma w into h w plus gamma sat into z for total stress. Neutral stress is equal to gamma w into h w plus gamma w into z. So sigma dash is equal to, sigma dash is equal to gamma w into h w. This can be written as another place. Sigma dash is equal to sigma minus u. What is sigma? Gamma w into h w plus gamma sat into z. Gamma w into h w plus gamma sat into z. Gamma sat into z. And pore water pressure gamma w into h w, unit weight of water, the particular depth, plus gamma w into z. Gamma w into h w minus plus gamma w into z plus gamma w into z. So here HW, here also HW. Gamma W into HW minus gamma W into HW, zero. Just here Z will be there, here Z will be there. So gamma sat minus gamma w into z. Gamma set minus gamma w is equal to gamma submerged, or we can written as gamma dash. Gamma submerged or gamma dash into z. So gamma dash into z. This is the another model of pressure distribution diagrams. Next model will be discussed in next class. Thank you.